Back to game number two. We have Evil versus Very Average Humans. Very Average Humans was able to take this one, is able to take one, and they hold the 1-0 series lead. Let me get everything situated here really quick. So Evil is on this side. Actually, we're gonna... All right, there we go. Now we got stuff working. All right, so early bans, Morgana, Senna, Vel'Koz coming off of the side of Very Average Humans with Set, Echo, and Olaf for the side of every every villain is Lemons for the side of Evil there. Evil once again electing to go with Misfortune and J4. We saw the Jarvan ulti combined with the bullet time locked down a couple times, and it was fairly successful, but the team was just too far behind. Janna to go alongside of the Misfortune to keep her safe from the Tristona and Leona, on the side of Very Average Humans, with Hecarim coming in the jungle pick. Sorry, getting things adjusted here. Alright, let's see. It looks like the MVP from game one was Frontlash with his absolute domination of the early game. And you could see, obviously, the bans from Evil. They didn't want to deal with that again. Absolutely bullied. 100% bullied the Evil top laner there in the first game. It's kind of one of those feels bad moments, you know. Kind of one of the feels bad moments. Alright, we did have a couple subs. Let's see, in the last game, while we're doing the pick bans, I will go through those really quick here. We had GG Mad Hatter coming with the 6 months Twitch Prime. Thank you so much, sir. May, yay, not May, hey, subscribed for 17 months. Currently on a 17-month streak. Thank you, sir. May, yay, not May, hey. Hopefully I won't miss your name up this game. Let's see. Karoot328 with the Twitch Prime for 17 months. 17 months old. Oh. Thanks so much, guys, for the subs, supporting the PMA LCS. Helping us do what we do, because, you know, obviously we wouldn't do it if it weren't for the money. Anyways, Maokai coming in for the side of Evil looks like he's going to be their top laner, and the response Fiora pick. I'm not honestly familiar with this matchup, to be quite honest with you. I don't know, let me look it up on our handy dandy op.gg here. Also, is the music too loud? Tell me if the music's too loud or if it's a good volume, by the way. I wanted to give it a little epic vibes. Ziggs coming in for the mid lane for the side of Very Average Humans. And Evil probably looking to get their mid lane pick here. Or they could flex Maokai mid and respond to Fiora top. You know, we'll see in just a few minutes. It is Rumble, and, you know, honestly not quite sure where these are going. This could be a Rumble top, or we could see it flex to mid, and I think that's going to work in their favor. We'll see once we get into the client. We'll see once we get into the actual lock-in. It's over. We are good to go here on the stream. Oh, I forgot to put the most important part. I forgot to put, you know, the most important part. My name, you know, it's casual. Okay, so it does look like, Do we have a substitute in that last game? I guess we did have a substitute. It looks like Juice Me Mommy, their top laner, is back in. Yeah, Juice Me Mommy, their top laner, is back in for the side of Evil. I guess that was just a substitute. And he'll be taking the Rumble top. Panic at the top hat will be going. Actually, no, they could, because Panic did go top lane last game. I don't know. We'll see how this goes. What do I know? I'm just a streamer. Before I started this, I don't think it did though. All right, is this a spicy? Is this spicy Maokai Min, says Guy Fieri? I don't know. We will see. We will see. Let's get the. That's not what you want. All right, players are locking in their final ones. It does look like it's going to be a Maokai mid unless Panic at the Top Hat decides to play top again, which I'm not sure why, because it looks like Juice Me Mommy, their original top laner, is back in the game. Unsure why they were well, they were swapped out, but I don't know. We'll see. Oh, thank you, Guy Fieri. This is game number two. VAH was able to take game number one in a fairly convincing fashion. I'll put that down in the chat. Let's see. Put that down in a. There we go. Did Did you? No, Juice Me Mama did not play game one. I'm unsure why. Didn't really receive information on why. So. Also curious to see why she did not, or he did not. I don't know. Maybe they were late. I don't think we were late because we didn't start late. I don't know. Maybe it's just a conflict and they just couldn't do game one. But alas, he's here for game number two. See if he can be the difference and they can pull out a one from one this week. Like we talked about earlier, kind of go, let's go through the standings one more time. Evil is sitting at the bottom of the table on the red side. They started today at 3-11. Now they are 3-12. So if they really want to start clawing their way back for a first round bye, it's got to start now, because you know Very Average Humans is holding on tightly to that fourth place spot. Actually, it looks like Bachelor Party is. It just hadn't been updated. But Very Average Human, Bachelor Party, both holding on to you know that tied for fourth kind of spot right there. So they got to start winning. They got to start winning now if they want that bye. Same with Very Average Humans, though. They just got to kind of keep doing what they're doing. It does look like next week they will face off Very Average Humans will against Bachelor Party. So not to look ahead or anything, but you know if we're looking at playoffs, you do look to see when the two teams vying for fourth place play each other, and that is the penultimate week, week number nine. So really excited to watch that match. And looks like we are getting into game number two very shortly once my computer loads. All right, let's get some music quiet down here. Once client's loaded, we will be good to go. Alrighty. Bye-bye. We are getting in here into game number two. Very Average Humans. Leading with a score of 1-0. A very convincing game one win for them. It's a very nice job by the guys on the side of VAH. These overlays going. Alrighty. Okay. It'll rip their hearts right out of their chest. All right. And we are underway here. Game number two, early blue pings. Heading up towards the Dragon Pit. Looks like they will do a traditional 5-point fan. While it does look like the side of Evil, I gotta get my sides right. Evil are all heading towards the bottom side of the map. Maybe either looking for a level 1 invade or kind of anticipating one. Can we remake Jake's skin as expletive? Got it. Oh, that's funny. Oh, got it. Hang on. Let me hit the transition button here. There we go. There we go. goodness gracious. Nothing like PMA brothers to meme each other.
Minions have spawned.
All right, gotta get these lined up. Boom. Early little level one, early one fight, level one fight coming down onto Juice Me Mommy. He's able to walk out with about half HP. Lugo's still really trying to pressure him. Not sure. I think he should just walk back, and they're Oh, goodness gracious, people. Lots of level one coming out, as opposed to last game where we saw just kind of a standard 5-point people kind of dance partying the whole time, but, you know. What's PMA LCS without a little memery? Speaking of memery, I love that Maokai skin. It's incredible. It is the best. Early CS lead coming down here for Front Lash. Very similar to the last game, kind of bullying Panic at the top hat. Oh, I need to switch this. So it looks like that is a Maokai top with a Rumble mid. It looks like they flexed it around. So interesting to see how this goes. Lots of damage coming down onto Allergic Milk. He will be taken to just above half HP with that bomb there from Tristana. Juice Me Mommy taken down very low, about 250 HP left just through trades. And, you know, Panic at the top hat with a level of, oh, well, was a level disadvantage. Now they're even. Biscuit hat unable to connect there with the E. Nice trade on the with Panic at the top hat onto Front Lash. You know, he has the level differential there, but he's able to trade back effectively. I bet they did pick the Maokai with the intent of a possible flex pick, but something that could respond to the Fiora if need be. Because, you know, Front Lash just had this absolutely pop-off game in game number one. So they wanted to see how well that they could respond to it. Make sure it didn't want it to happen again. But we do see some early CS leads coming in the mid lane for Lugo. Not really surprising, as we saw that level one, we saw Juice Me Mommy get chunked down really hard, about half HP, and, you know, basically... Oh, nice fight. Nice EQ combo going down onto Chad Penguin. Flash is burned for Chad Penguin. She's going to do a little bit of damage back to him. Great engage there by Biscuit Hat. And OP to jump in, and oh, another great engage by Biscuit Hat. Able to get onto Allergic Milk, but OP's not really in range to follow that one up. But in the end, only a little bit of trade damage going down. No harm, no foul. Gank going down in the mid lane. Meiye going on to Juice Me Mommy. He's taking very low down to about 200 HP. So not feeling good for Juice Me Mommy in this early game. Down 10 CS already. Nice dodge there by... Uh-oh, I'm not sure about that, OP. Going into a little farm. Forced to flash out. Yeah, I think he kind of anticipated Biscuit Hat to land that, and I thought it was going to as well, but it looks like it was just out of range. Juice Me Mommy still taking so much damage in the mid lane. Panic at the top hat. Going in on to Front Lash, but Front Lash is able to get the stun and trade back damage by the equal trade. Our first dragon coming up right now, it is going to be a Cloud Drake, just like last game, starting with early Cloud Drake. Juice Me Mommy taking very low. This is Lugo, needs only one more hit. Flash burn by Juice Me Mommy, taking so very low, so very low. He's not having a fun game. Down nearly 20 farm at 5 minutes. Lugo just absolutely punishing this level one advantage he was able to get for himself. We've been talking about the CS differential in the mid lane. Look at the one in the top lane. Front Lash, once again, able, even though these trades are going by equal, he's able to get himself a 13 CS lead. That is very good. Let's check out the gold differentials just based off farm. In the mid lane, you see Lugo right there with about a little over 500 gold. Oh, nice damage going out under Front Lash. Panic at the top end. Maybe he's able to get the first kill. Now he's going to back off. Nice damage down. And that feels good when you're down that much CS. An action, even though it was an action-packed, you know, first 6 minutes of the game, no kills have gone down so far. A little bit of poke, kind of delaying the back from front lash there. Very nicely done. Front lash is taken very low, even though he's under tower, he's taken incredibly low. Even though Meiye's, you know, kind of hanging around, making sure his top lane is safe. Looks like he's pathing towards the mid lane to try to punish this Juice Me Mommy, who has no flash. Remember, has no flash on the Rumble, was down very early level 1. As a result, down about over 20 CS. Pink's coming in from Meiye. Looks like he's going in for a top lane dive. Ulti pops, and it's going to be nothing doing. We see a counterspell now pathing towards the bot side. OP, remember, doesn't have flash, even though he has his... can jump away. Juice Me Mommy taking. Meanwhile, Juice Me Mommy taking lots of damage in the mid lane once again, taking town to about 100 HP. Lugo flashes and is able to secure first blood under their tower. That level 1 advantage. You know, oh, nice engage onto Allergic to Milk there. He's taken very low though, but he will be able to get out, and very quickly they're off to a 2,000 gold lead off CS and just two very, very fast kills. Front Lash just whacking away at this tower, not even caring in the world that Panic at the top hat is right there in his face. Oh man. Feels bad. And with those two early kills, it looks like VAH are going to be able to secure the first dragon. Very nicely done by them. Able to get a solo kill in the mid lane and another kill onto Janna under the tower. She wasn't even able to flash away from that one. So, very nicely done. Nice trades going down onto the top lane. So far, equal. Frontlash is low on mana, though, so he needs to be very careful. He's able to force back Panic at the top hat once again. It's just felt like the entire series, Frontlash is just bullying his lane opponent this whole time. Very nicely done by him. See some more trades going down. Nice damage on the Frontlash to force him back. That may even force it back. Yep, and Frontlash has no TP. He used it earlier in the game, so he's got to make the long trek back. Ultimate going down onto Lugo. Equalizer going down from Juice Me Mommy. EQ combo misses, but the Cataclysm comes in. Counterspell, is he able to take down Lugo? One more auto will do it, and he will take him down, and they will get a kill back for themselves for the mid laner. What a fantastic tornado. Oh man, that feels bad. Oh, Biscuit, we've been there before. Great tornado by Allergic to Milk to stop that Leona engage. That would have been very, very not good. Another great tornado. Oh my goodness, Chris is Allergic to Milk, showing everyone how we play Janna. Opie's taken very low. Looks like just kind of split targets. I really would like to see, you know, either side focus on one person. It looked like, you know, the Leona was targeted and the Tristana was targeted. And, you know, if either side would have kind of committed to one target, I really feel like one of them would have secured a kill. It was very, very even. But it also looked like very kind of disjointed from both sides. But, you know, other than, I don't even believe a flash was burned, you know, other than just kind of a big trade. Oh, looking to get a cheese here. Nice rear on a Chad Penguin. Opie taken very low. This guy's able to get out. Multiple ultimates burned. Once again, nice ultimate on this from Allergic to Milk. See if they get a kill. And the Allergic Mill does get the kill. Biscuit has soon to follow. That is a 2-4-0. Very long-winded fights here. You know, those two kills were set up about 3 fights ago. And just constant trading. And, you know, also it's the CS lead. I want to take a look at the gold now. Because, you know, Misfortune is up 40 farm. Wow. Chad Penguin's up 40 farm onto Opie. That is nearly 1,000 gold. Juice Me Mommy caught between a rock and a hard place, but direct cameras are going to take us topside. And Frontlash, looks like he might be taken down. Jessica, flash. And I guess he will be taken down. Mei's going into counterspell. That's a double kill for Lugo. Absolutely tearing up this game. He is up now almost 2,000 gold over his Elaine opponent. Lugo's absolutely tearing it up. Absolutely tearing it up. So the gold does look even, right? Across the board, you know, it's only about a 600, about an 800 gold deficit for the side of Evil. But the advantages are on different sides of the map. You got one kind of in a, looks like Mei is looking for something here on allergic to milk. He's not able to get it. Obi jumps in, and that'll be able to get it. Opie does secure that kill, so that'll feel good. You know, he was down almost 1,000 gold, and that one brought him back within about 300. Very nicely done from him to kind of get back into this game, into the bottom lane. Viscahat able to get the stun down. Not much of a follow-up, though, so no harm done. It does look like here, Evil will go for this Rift Herald, and they will secure it very uncontested. It looks like J4 is going to be pathing towards the top side of the map here. See if they can get something onto Lugo. That would be a absolutely huge thing with his bounty on his head. He does have flash available, so he should be able to get it out relatively easy. Nice root. And he will go down. Flash burn and everything. Let's see if they look to push even more or drop the Rift Herald here. And it does look like that is the play to get the last two plates. Remember, the last two plates are the tankiest ones, so that's the ones you do want to take the Rift Herald onto. Nice engage onto Mei. He's taken very low and will be taken down, but we do have a pause. Of course we have a pause. Why not? What's going on? Let's see here. We want to see why the pause is happening. That's it's incredibly convenient time to pause the game in the middle of a fight. Okay. So while we're here, let's just take a look at some items on. All right, Lugo's unpause the game in 3, 2, 1. Here we go. And with the Herald, as I was saying earlier. If you did not know, the last two plates on a turret are tankier than the first three. Okay, so you'll see proteins a lot. It looks like they're holding on to the Baron. Oh, nice damage! Great ultimate by the Fiora to kind of negate the bullet time, but not able to stay alive. And Ping's going down towards the dragon. We see both teams somewhat pathing in that direction. But as I was saying. You know, you'll see pro teams a lot. They'll hit a tower a couple times, get a plate, and then drop the Herald at the very end to get as much damage down onto it. So very nicely done by them to secure, I think that might have been first turret. Unsure, I think the mid lane turret was first, actually. But we do see maybe potentially a fight going down in the Dragon Pit. But it does look like, smartly, very average humans does decide to get this over. Very nicely done. They're able to take that pick of the Fiora that they made in the mid lane and turn that into a dragon play for them. Fiora doing what Fiora does best, just, you know, split pushing. A nice calm break. We've had an action-packed game, so these breaks are very nice to sit back and think about what's going on. You know, we've got a 25 CS lead in the bot lane that has transferred into a 400 gold lead. But in the mid lane, that's the story of this game. Almost 3,000 gold up. But counterspell EQs out, flashes away. Oh, Lugo from downtown. Oh my goodness, he says Kobe and just launches it. Able to take out Counterspell. Looks like they're going to try to collapse onto Mei here. Nice ultimate down from Panic at the top hat, but he is in a 2v1. Got to wait. Nice. Oh, great bullet time coming in. Biscuit Hat taken very low. Looks like he, maybe next note, he will get out on time. Lugo is kind of caught out by himself. Biscuit Hat coming to save the day, but I'm not sure that's what we want to be because, you know. Well, it does look like they will get out safely because Front Lash is coming down to help him out. Okay, so this game is very strange. On one hand, the goal differential is 2,000 for the side of Very Average Humans, and it looks like that goal differential has been equated to two things. Oh, it looks like we may have a fight going on the... So the goal differential there is equated to two things. One, they do have a 3-1 tower lead, so that feels very nice. But really, the farm lead in the mid lane and the jungle and top lane are what's standing out. Because, you know, like I said, over 3,000 gold, maybe 3,500 gold between the two mid laners in this game. That's not what you want to see if you're Juice Me Mommy, you know. But we've seen tighter spots, you know. This is definitely not an insurmountable lead. It's only like what, 3,500 gold, and that gold differential actually is represented in the mid lane alone, you know. So if you can get on top of the Fizz, I think you can win fights, especially if you can combo the Jarvan ultimate with the bullet time for Misfortune. You can really make some things happen out of fights, and I think that's what they've been doing so far. So very nicely done for Lugo to really kind of be that carry on his team. Biscuit Hat may have been up a little more than he can chew. TP coming down. Nice bullet time onto Lugo, but it's not able to take him down. He's still taking very, very low, about a 100 HP. He will be taken down. Chad Penguin's on a rampage. It's a 2-0 so far, and they're not stopping. Front Lash going in on a panic at the top, has taken very low. Ultimate down on a Front Lash. That is a 3-0. Chad Penguin is unstoppable. 250 gold bounty. He's got 2,000 gold in his pocket, ready to spend it at money. And he is up 500 gold on his lane opponent, who is not even doing that bad right now, if I do say so myself. Counterspell going on to Meihei. Meihei. I'm starting to get the name right. Going on to Meihei, able to pick up that kill on him. So, like I said, you know, that's how you are able to come back. It started kind of with Biscuit Hat, a little overextended, you know, as a support player, I can kind of understand, you know, going for that. Trying to get a little bit extra vision for your team. You know, you see that happen to support. I'm trying, bro. Yeah, I mean, you see supports very often, especially in, you know, lower tiers, trying to get that little vision advantage for their team, but ultimately, you know, getting caught out just ever so slightly. And that's kind of how it started. Biscuit Hat got taken out. Wasn't able to use the Solar Flare in that fight, but it looks like they will go on to Panic at the Top Hat here. But you see the question mark pings coming out of the river. Good job from them to back down. And that's just when we back up. We don't want to get caught out once again. Go back to the tower and just reset. Nice solar flare to stop the engage there. But Biscuit Hat decides to go back in. Nice ultimate from the Vista. So much damage from Lugo, taking multiple members down to about 300 HP. Chad Penguin is dominating, but immediately dies. Juice Me Mommy still alive. Opie still going onto the back line. He flashes forward. Also another flash burn by Allergic Milk. And Panic at the Top Hat will go down to Lugo. My goodness gracious, it is a 3-4-1 for the side of Very Average Humans. Goodness gracious. Oh, I can't get over that Fizz ultimate. That was absolutely crazy. And as a result, they're going to earn themselves a nice, juicy Ocean Drake. Oh, goodness gracious. So they will definitely enjoy that extra healing to go on top of their ulti regens, or ulti cooldowns, I guess you can say. Flash maybe stayed his welcome over a little bit too long. They're taking very low. Counter spells on a killing spree. Not quite sure about that one, Front Lash. But yeah, this game is just back and forth, back and forth. Still able to hold a 4,000 gold lead. As you can see down kind of at the bottom right here, you can see it's really just in the mid lane. It's a 4,000 gold differential in the mid lane, you know. 300 in top, about even in the mid. Almost 1,000, you know, it's... It's mid lane difference right now. Lugo is going absolutely huge. He's building towards his Rabadons right now. He's already got Ludens and Morel and Omicron. You know, he is the carry. And I think that's how they won that previous fight. You know, they won the fight in the jungle by getting the early pick onto Biscuit Hat, soon followed by the pick onto Lugo, and they were able to really win that fight fairly convincingly. But you saw in the last fight the power of the ultimate. It's just absolutely crazy what Lugo is able to do on this champion right now. Hecarim is able to purchase the Trinity Force, so that's going to feel good. Redemption going down. Lugo, Biscuit Hat, trying to clear out a little bit of vision here. And you do see now that the next dragon's in 317. The teams are trying to get their vision set up around the top side of the map. Another kind of risky step up, but you know, no harm done. Looks like a fight about to break out here. Lugo, remember, Lugo's the main target. He's the main carry on this side. Does lots of damage. Mei is slain by Juice by Mommy. And Lugo is still doing more damage. His ulti goes down. Nice drive in ulti, but it doesn't even matter. He dies immediately. Allergic to milk, soon to follow for sure by the side of Mei. On the bottom side, you have Frontlash and Panic at the top hat. Almost said Panic at the Disco. Panic at the top hat fighting each other in a split push battle. Frontlash being taken very, very low. He needs to care here. Able to sidestep the ultimate there from the Maokai. And both players are able to get out. Lugo looks like he will take down this inhibitor right here. And that feels good for his side. 7-3-2, a 300 gold bounty on his next back. Surely, yeah, he's sitting on 1,400 gold. I believe on his next back, he can probably afford the Rabadon's death cap. Looks like that's what he's building for. Watch me be completely wrong. I don't know. I play AD carry and support. AP items are not too familiar with me. Anyways, that looks like what he is building for, but he has just built up this insurmountable lead for his team. It's now almost double the gold of his opponent. Yep, and there it is. As you can see you can't see it on the chat. Rabadon's death cap coming in for this is Lugo, and OP picking up the Infinity Edge for himself. So that feels good on both of the primary carries here for very average humans. So, reminder, they do hold a lead here in this series, 1-0. If they are able to take this game, they will take the series and really more further, make their journey to having a playoff bye a lot easier. Because they do play VP next week, and that'll be certainly an interesting game to watch heading into playoffs. But we do have a really nice flank coming in here. As you can see on the mini map, counterspell going in. Nice ultimate. Oh my goodness, so much damage. Oh my goodness, Lugo, so much damage from so far away. As a clean ace. 23 seconds on the lowest member. They could potentially look to end here. This guy taking very low from that turret, but I think they'll just look to end here. Once again, fantastic job. GG's going down for both sides. Game 2, certainly a lot more... I did kill a dragon this game. Game 2, certainly a lot more competitive than Game 1. But Lugo on the mid lane zigs. Golly. Ugh. GG's all around. Alrighty. Okay. Okay. While we get the straw poll going, GG's everybody, MVP link. I will get that as soon as I can. It's .me. Straw poll. All right, while I do this, I want to see people's thoughts in the chat once I come back. Give me just a few minutes while I make this here really quick. We had Frontlash. Okay. Hey, you know what? I may have made a meme tonight by accident. All right, straw poll down. The game two straw poll has been put down. Interesting. Really brought out a different... Thank you, Clumsy. Thank you. I enjoy it. I enjoy bringing out different atmospheres. Do I need it? Have I done my Prime sub? I'm gonna gift a sub. Let's see, who should I gift a sub to? Let's see here. I might give one later. We'll see. All right, we'll have about 2 to 3 more minutes on the, Oh, I need to edit the who wins. Actually, hang on 1 second. Get rid of this. Please don't vote for MVP game 2. I added 0-4-0. Yeah, I was looking at those results and I was like, guys? Question mark ping? Question mark? If you don't vote for Lugo, you're a troll. And that includes Lugo. Team Frontlash. Oh, man. You can't deny the will of the people, says Narco Guy. Okay, so chat, this is my like first time streaming. I wanted to experiment with some things. How are the levels, like the music levels, both in game, or the levels and audio levels in general, in game and lobby and stuff like that? We'll give about 2 more minutes on the straw poll. By the way, I don't know what that means. Does that mean I'm really loud? All right, I'm gonna go ahead and join. All All right. Let's see. Straw poll results. Let's refresh here. Okay, so we have a tie between Frontlash and Lugo, but I'm going to give it to Lugo because his Ziggs ultimates were absolutely just nutty. So Lugo was the Game 2 MVP, Frontlash Game 1 MVP. If you guys could come join me in Player of the Game 1, I'm happy to come and talk to you guys. Oh, he did? Ah, he pulled out one by one. Look at that. Well, anyways, I say he wins, so he wins. And we've got our two guys here.
What's up?
What's up, boys? Let's see. Lugo, talk for me.
About?
I'm just getting levels. Frontlash, talk for me.
Hi.
All right, cool. Okay, so I want to start with game one.
It's a good place to start.
Okay, so Frontlash.
What's up?
Walk me through your early game. Because from my point of view, it just kind of looked like you were just bullying that with the set pick. It was kind of nutty. So just kind of walk me through your mindset going into that game.
All right. If I get set, I'm not going to lie. I go to listenonrepeat.com and I throw in JoJo's Bizarre Adventure Golden Wind OST Giorno's theme. I just listen to it on repeat while I play. I'm pretty sure that JoJo energy just kind of flows through me while I'm playing set. So,
well, it certainly came through on that game. Let me go through. Is there a way to look at the matches that I spectated? Okay, it's not. All right. All right, yeah, very nice, and really great games from both you guys and your team in general. So going into playoffs, we got about 2 weeks left. Talk to me, Lugo, about your team's kind of mentality heading into the last couple weeks of the season.
So I guess our mentality is kind of the same mentality we have, just keep trying to get better and then try not memeing too hard.
Not memeing too hard. Speaking of meme. Frontlash, why did you have to do the sit-ups in their base, man?
Come I knew. I knew they were all coming. I needed to get a couple reps out right before I made Miss Fortune blow flash. All right.
So. that's really good. That's really good, Lugo. So, looking to potentially get a round one by. But Lugo, talk to me about your game too. And while he's doing that, hang on one second. While he's doing that, chat, go ahead and ask any questions you've got in the chat for our guests here. But Lugo, talk to me about game two. Absolutely popping off on Ziggs. Ultimates came down huge. Especially the one I freaked out about most was in the bot lane. You had one that knocked about multiple people down to about 200 HP and really turned that fight around. So talk to me. Walk me through your gameplay.
So I guess I couldn't have done that until the start of the... Basically... The game never went Rumble's way, and I felt kind of bad because he got caught out at the beginning, and I just chunked him out. And then at that point, the lane was over. Jarvan needed to come a lot sooner, to release that pressure, because I just kept pressure, and I think I was 20 CS up on him already at 40 CS to 20.
Yeah, it was kind of crazy, and it was that level one that you were talking about. I believe you chunked him down to about half HP. Before he even saw a minion, so that really feels bad. But very very nice job from both you guys. The game one team wise was really impressive, and so game two was a little bit more of a struggle. There was some fights that were kind of questionable where a couple of your members got caught out. So talk to me, I guess kind of the what happened in game two. Why wasn't it as it didn't seem as smooth as game one?
I feel honestly, I thought game two was. Smoother. Really? I think it was a little bit faster. Okay. I have to look at the times, but I think game two was. I wouldn't say it was smoother. Obviously our team fights were a little bit different. That's what I'd just say. I'd say the games were different. Yeah, it was about it was 30 seconds faster, and I think that's a lot of that was because we kind of played a different style. We were winning not necessarily in team fights. We were winning the map. We were rotating better.
Whereas
the first game we were just trying to look for those good team fights, but the second game we were willing to give up, we were willing to die to get tower, and we just blatantly took towers and was pushing much harder.
And I mentioned that on stream. You guys, it seemed like over and over again there were fights that ended either 2-for-2 or 3-for-2 on either side, but you guys were constantly. I vividly remember there being a fight in the river, and front lash, you were just splitting top, and you like took a tower, while the fight was going on. Either that or Lugo, it was just there was always. Even though it didn't seem like the best situation, you guys were able to turn it into something really good. So props to you on that. Chat, you got any questions?
I don't see the chat.
I don't think they got anything. Do you guys have anything you want to add?
I think I'm good.
Yeah, I'm good.
All right.
Go check out the other PMA LCS game that's happening over on
Chad Penguin
stream here. Let me spam that link in the chat a couple more times. But go support the PMA LCS.
Question. Oh, we do have a question for Opie. Question for Frontlash. How is your first game different from your second? Because you're on a set strong game one and a Fiora own four.
I mean, so set's just kind of nuts. It's really strong. Fiora's definitely not top tier right now, and I more picked her just because I knew that unless I really goofed, I wouldn't die top lane without a gank, and late game I'd just be able to split push anyways, so I didn't really play Fiora to bully Maokai out of lane. Maokai is one of those characters that's just kind of tanky for no good reason, so even early on you can't really bully him out with someone like Fiora, so that's why I didn't really play for the early game in game two, but I did in game one.
Okay. Yeah, that does make sense. And I was thinking about that because Fiora is really just a really strong split push champion. And, you know, the game didn't really go long enough for that to really come
to fruition. I still got to get a lot of damage on side towers when objectives were up and stuff. So yeah, it served its purpose. I might have gotten a kill or two as the game drew out longer, but.
Sure. Yeah,
for we
sure.
got that clean fight 4v5. 5-0 mid lane, so we all just pushed down mid and won.
Yeah. Overall, great games by you guys. If you don't have anything else, we're going to cut it there. Y'all have a fantastic night. Like Frontlash said, go check the other game out. Who is that? Who's playing right now? Let me check.
That's going to be level 18 versus HOTS.
Ah, yeah. Level 18 versus HOTS. They're currently in a game pause. Feels good. All right.
That's PMA LCS for you.
That's PMA LCS for you. All right. Y'all have a great night. We'll catch you all tomorrow. VAH with a commanding 2-0 win over Evil, and they are moving closer and closer to having a playoff bye. Everybody have a great night, and see you later.